every human being, that when we ponder over Quran and we try to understand it, we should have two levels of understanding of each and every ayah. First of all, we have to keep the ayat or the surahs in the context, the historical context, when they were revealed, to whom they were revealed, who were the first addressees of the Quran, to whom Quran was talking primarily, what were their ideas, what were their beliefs, what were their customs, what were their rituals. Everything has to be in the context, geo-historical context, that we call in the term of the exegesis of the Quran, Ta'wilul Khas, with the special, you know, perspective of the time when they were revealed, people who were being directly addressed. If we place the ayah or the surah in that context, and then we try to understand what was the meaning of this ayah or surah, which the people understood at that time, at that particular moment in history. And secondly, because this Quran is meant for the whole of humanity, for all times to come. It was not sent only for the Arabs. It was not sent only for the Christians or the Jews of the times of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but the whole humanity. So actually we have to understand the Quran secondarily in a generalized way. That is called the Ta'wilul Aam. Look to the words, what they mean, and just don't keep them bound with the background, historical background. Take it away from that background, and as such, you think over them, ponder over them, dive deep into their meanings, and try to generally infer from it the total and the final and the eternal guidance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided for the humanity at large.